Entschuldigung, was sollen die Kamera hier kosten?
So 70 Euro.
Isn't that the story we were all waiting for? To find a Leica M6 on a flea market for 70 bucks? But I'm sorry to disappoint you, because this is not how it happened. If you want to know the real story, you should stay tuned.
Story time! If you have watched part 1 of this video, you already know the reasons why I decided to buy a Leica M6. If you haven't watched part 1 of this video, you can stop right here, check it out and come back later.
But you can also be a rebel and watch part 1 after part 2.
Wanting or deciding for a camera and in the end really buying that camera are two completely different types of stories. And I mean, the stories with digital cameras are often not as exciting because they usually look like this. You want a camera, you walk into a camera shop without a camera, and you walk out of that shop with a camera. Or you do two clicks on Amazon and the next day you will have your camera delivered to your door. But not so with analog cameras, because these cameras usually have a longer history on their back and most of the camera shops do not have them in stock. They are not sold on Amazon. Therefore, analog cameras are a bit harder to find, also regarding the condition you would wish your camera to be in. Of course, there are also eBay resellers that are selling analog cameras with a one-click solution, but me personally, I avoid doing this and I would never buy a camera without having them in my hand and without testing them properly. So for me, it was clear from the start, before my Leica story even began, that I wanted to find one locally or within a range I could comfortably travel to test it out before buying. The story how I got my Leica M6 started around the time when I decided that I wanted to buy one. And I think this must have been around 1.5 years ago. As I mentioned, back then I was still a student, so I knew that this would take some time until I could finally afford one. And one thing I really love to do in order to afford photography equipment or anything that is related to cameras or photography is trying to make money by photography or by cameras. And that's also exactly what I did, which is part one of the story how I got my Leica M6, because I collected money by reselling cameras. This might not be something for everybody, but for me it also grew into a small little hobby, because I started to go on flea markets and buy cameras, mostly point and shoots. Then I would take them home, take very good care of them, which means that I would properly clean them, I would replace light seals, I would clean off corrosed batteries, do some minor repair things, but most importantly film testing them. Not only did it have the advantage that it filled my Leica jars slowly but constantly, but I also think that I made a tiny small contribution to helping have working and film tested cameras around that people could buy. So after some time doing this, I would say I had maybe around half of the money in my jar that I would need to buy a Leica body. But then something happened that I was wishing for in this Leica story, but that actually happened too early, because I found a Leica M6 in the local camera shop where I live. But to get to this point, we will have to rewind a little bit more. This all happened last year. But to be honest, last year was a quite tough year for me and my family, because a very close family member, my uncle, passed away last year. And my father, my uncle and I, we all have birthday around the same time. It's only a couple of days apart. So it was always a big kind of family tradition that we would celebrate our birthdays together and we would spend the time with the family. And this would be the first year somebody was missing, but to still keep the tradition up, I decided to still go visit my family. But in order to also cope with the loss, I decided to take some more family pictures in the time when I'm traveling there, and also do a little project to visit spots that were very important for me during my childhood. So when I was packing the things for my trip, I suddenly realized that I do not have enough film, and this almost never happens because I do usually have a good amount of film in my fridge. So I knew that before going to my parents' place, I should definitely buy some film. There is no camera shop in the city where my parents live, so I knew that I would have to grab some film in the city where I'm living. And there are two camera shops. One is in the city center and one is right by the train station. And usually I would mostly go to the one in the city center, just because it has a wider variety of films to pick from. But this time, since I planned to take the next train, I decided to just quickly hop by the camera shop that is near the train station. So on my way to the shop, I wanted to see what films they do have in stock so I could prepare what films I would buy. And they had a small little secondhand section that I just out of fun checked out. And then I couldn't trust my eyes because there, back on the top page, was a Leica M6 Titanium for a very, very reasonable price. And in my mind, I was seriously freaking out, like, what? No, this can't be. This is the opportunity I was waiting for, but I do not have the money. And this will probably be gone in no time. So I was already like thinking and didn't know what to do, because there was this opportunity. There was a Leica M6, good condition, good price, right where I live, from a seller, not from a private, you know, person selling it. And I did only have half of the budget. I went into that shop and I bought my film, and I just couldn't leave without taking a look at that Leica. So I asked them that I saw that they have a M6 in their online shop, if it would be possible to take a look at it. They handed me the M6 and I could test it out. And that's when I completely fell in love with this version, because I had never seen a titanium version before. Seriously, like, this was all I was waiting for. But I thought, no, this is a joke. Why now? Couldn't this be like half a year later, or maybe a year later, when I could afford it? And it was like more of a impulsive thing, but I asked the guy who was working there if there would be any way to reserve this camera, and if yes, for what period of time this would be possible. So he told me that they could do a reservation, but the maximum amount was 1 week. And out of the blue, I just said, yeah, I'm gonna reserve it. And I left the shop and I had my reservation number, and I was like, what did I just do? I don't have the money. I cannot buy this. How shall I come up with the money within a week? And also, I'm at my parents' place now. How on earth shall this work? I went home to my parents' place, I took some pictures, it was my birthday, and there were some very lovely people who were thinking about me, who made me some gifts, and some of the gifts were also monetary. So some money was added to the Leica jar, but it was still not enough to buy the M6. Then something happened I really didn't account for, because I received one last gift on my birthday. And this was from my uncle, who passed away. He knew ahead of time that his time would come, so he prepared a couple of things, and one of those things was also a gift for me, which would be enough to buy the Leica M6. This was a total turning event for me. I did never account for this money, and it suddenly made me doubt everything. Like, one second I was thinking, yes, this is meant to be. This is, you know, the right timing. I should buy this Leica. And then the next second I thought, no, this money is too important and too valuable and too emotional to spend it on a camera. And then I decided to just look it up online in the store again, to see the pictures and kind of look at it again and try to make a decision. And when I went on their page and I tried to look for the Leica M6, it was gone. And I was freaking out. I was seriously freaking out, because in that second I realized, yes, I do have the money now, and yes, I want to buy it, but they do not have it anymore. I was freaking out. I immediately grabbed the phone and I called them, and I was like, that was the Leica M6, where is it? And he was like super chill, and he said, well, you just said you had a reservation, right? So we took it out of the store so it would be reserved for you. So we still have it, and if you want it, you should pick it up, and otherwise we will put it in the online shop again. And just this little freak out of mine, calling them and asking if they sold the camera. That's the second where I realized, okay, I think the money that I suddenly have is well spent if I do make this decision and I buy it. After celebrating all our birthdays, my uncle's birthday on that same day, I took the train home because I had work the next day, and the first thing I did was to walk into that camera shop again and buy the Leica. It is in seriously perfect condition. All the shutter speed work perfectly fine. The only thing is that it has a tiny little nick here, which I do not really mind and I don't really notice it. But this is the reason why they sold it for cheap. And it still has this sticker on the bottom plate, which just shows that it's really in beautiful condition. But since I did not only buy the body, but I bought it with the lens, they gave me an additional discount. But I also received a receipt and a warranty for this camera, because this is a camera shop. Now, taking a look back and just seeing all those coincidences piling up and making me not only see but also buy this Leica M6, are mind-blowing for me. First up, I do usually always have film in stock. And if I do not, I would usually order it online. But this time, I didn't only order it online, but I bought it locally in the shop I would usually not go to. And then, from a sudden outburst, suddenly reserving the camera, even though I did not have the budget yet, is also not that typical for me. Not only suddenly receiving the budget out of nowhere, which I didn't account for, but also receiving it from a very beloved and very, very missed person. And then buying this camera on that person's birthday, on my uncle's birthday, is just too much for me to handle, and just seriously thinking that this was meant to be. So in the end, I think this was the right decision to buy the camera, and I couldn't be happier. And I have to say that I will probably never ever get this away again, just because I do not only love this camera for its mechanics and for the reasons that I mentioned in the first video, but also for the story that is behind it. Because every time I pick up this camera, I think about my family, I think about my uncle, and this might sound super cheesy and super sentimental, but I truly believe it. This just made me realize again and again how important it is to make memories, to snap photos of your family, of your beloved ones, to freeze time and just capture the moment as long as you can still do so. So I hope that you got an insight into why I love this camera so much, because it's not only for its technicalities, but also for its tiny little metal iron heart, but also for what it represents for me. I would love to hear your story, how you got your camera. If there's funny, sad, crazy, whatever stories, you can let them in the comments down below, and I would love to read them. That said, I would say, see you next time.